Hello and welcome to the Quincy Access Television Studios. I'm Mark Crosby, bringing you today Fire Prevention and You, a program that has been on hiatus for a while, but it is now back. And joining me in the studio from the Fire Prevention Bureau here in the city of Quincy is Mike Slade. Mike, welcome.
Thank you, Mark. Thanks for having me.
Pleasure to have you. Hopefully, this will be a series that we will put together topics of importance for folks. Of course, safety is utmost importance here in the city for everybody. And I thought we should begin this particular program we are actually recording at the beginning of June, perfect for talking about grill safety. We will get to that in a bit, but just if you could just talk about your office, talk a little bit about outreach.
Sure. So, like you said, my name is Mike Slade. I work in the Fire Prevention Office. So we do fire prevention, it's in our title. We do inspections, investigations. So yeah, that's pretty much
it. And education.
Education is a big part of what we do, absolutely.
The Quincy Sun, how did that come about? Writing a column for the weekly newspaper.
Sure, I mean, my chief, Joe Barron, that's always been on the forefront of his mind is to make sure that fire prevention continues to educate the public each year. We receive grants that helps us to do that throughout every school. We do the senior citizens as well. So yeah, it's a pretty active thing that we do in fire prevention.
And of course, you're looking at Quincy Access Television as another vehicle?
Absolutely, yeah. To be in front of viewers for the city of Quincy, the citizens, is great. It's a great tool to have.
Your time here in the Quincy Fire Department, how many years?
I've been on the Quincy Fire Department for 13 years.
Okay, so you've seen the city of Quincy grow. And as the population increases, there's naturally, well, the public safety departments need to increase to meet the needs, correct?
Absolutely, absolutely.
And how would you say the city of Quincy, I think I know the answer to this, fares as far as personnel in the fire department compared to the numbers as far as residents are concerned?
Well, we have 8 stations strategically located throughout the city of Quincy. Our response time has continued to be 3 minutes or less. So we just put on the biggest class, I believe, ever in the fire department.
It was impressive. I was there.
Yeah, it was 27 firefighters who went through a long process of being interviewed, and they're very squared away. So we're excited to have them, and it's important to have the minimum standard of, you know, 1 officer and 3 firefighters on every piece. So it looks like we have that right now, and I'm grateful that we can do that and continue to keep the residents as safe as possible.
Very good. Let's talk a little bit about some statistics. I know you came with some updated statistics regarding fires and response to fires throughout the city. I think we are looking at somewhere a period from January 1st of this year to about now.
Yeah, I mean, I have the total as of June 1st of 2017. So in the city of Quincy, we've had 245 fires, and we've had 2,515 medical calls, and the medical calls include rescues. It's been very busy. You don't hear about that many fires. Like I said, Quincy Fire Department has a response time of less than 3 minutes, so
right.
we are quick to knock down fires in most cases. So,
and a big part of that is again not having the fires even happen in the first place.
Fire prevention,
right?
Absolutely.
Which brings us to today's show. And I would like to get into, before we give out specific points for folks regarding grill safety, talk a little bit about fires and grill fires in relation to Massachusetts.
Sure. So from 2011 to 2015, Massachusetts fire departments responded to 431 fires involving grills, hibachis, and barbecues. In those fires, there were 20 civilian injuries, and there were 3 firefighter injuries, and total damage was about $3.5 million.
How do we prevent grill fires? What should folks be aware of? I guess I will start. We will have some information on screen so folks can continue or can follow along.
Sure.
Let's start with always grill outdoors. Talk about the importance of that.
Always grill outdoors. I can give you an example that we had a few years ago. where there was a fatality in the city. I'm not sure of the details, but it did involve a hibachi inside. So you had the coals inside, and it was given off a gas of CO, so carbon monoxide poisoning. It's odorless, you can't taste it, you can't smell it,
right.
But yet it can kill you. It can be sort of like flu-like symptoms, but you won't, you know, there can be no evidence of it being there.
Right.
So there was a fatality in Quincy involving a hibachi indoors. So we want to be careful that wherever you're doing your grilling, it is outdoors, and it's in a well-ventilated area.
We'll talk about outside maybe and overhangs.
Overhangs, yeah. So heat rises, right? So you want to keep the grills that you're using at least 10 feet away from any structure, any roof. You shouldn't have a roof over your grill unless it's well ventilated.
Okay.
So my own house, you know, we have a kind of like a commercial setup where I do have an electric fan that will take. So I'm cooking underneath the roof, but it's set up properly to be able to handle it and ventilate the heat away from you.
I would imagine that your house is quite a safe place to be when it comes to preventing fires.
Absolutely, it is.
It certainly
indeed.
Should be.
Right.
Never grill on a fire escape.
Never grill on a fire escape. Never grill on the second floor of a home or even close to the first floor of your home. Propane is heavier than air. So if you have someone doing whatever on the first floor, cooking, let's say, and that, you know, someone's on their second floor balcony cooking, which is against the law, you cannot do that. But let's say if they are, propane does, it is heavier than air, so you can cause a pretty chaotic scene by doing that.
And we've heard about instances where the fire will go up the side of the structure.
Absolutely. Absolutely. And we've responded to numerous fires involving grills on the outside where we'll get there and it's going right up the side of the house.
Right. Let's talk about matches, mm-hmm. lighters, lighter fluid, mm-hmm. as far as keeping it away from kids.
Oh yeah, that's very important. So kids, yeah, you definitely want to, when you use those, you want to keep it away from the grill itself once you use it, and put it away once you've used it. Just make sure that children have no access to that whatsoever.
And just the grilling area, children and pets as well, should be kept away.
Yep.
Not only can children knock things over or bump into things, pets do, and they often can cause problems.
Absolutely, yeah. A friend of mine has a blind dog, and you see him bouncing off the walls. You know, I mean, you just want to make sure your pets stay away from the grill. Yeah.
Let's talk about starting the grill and the importance of having the cover up.
Sure. So if you have a propane grill, let's say, and you have the grill off, and you go to ignite it, propane can build up and cause a massive explosion. And we have seen injuries where that's the grill has popped off and hurt people. So you want to be careful that when you're lighting the grill, the cover is off.
Take out that element of the buildup of gas.
Absolutely, absolutely well ventilated.
What happens if you smell gas?
If you smell gas, shut off the grill right away. Get away from the grill, call 911. So call 911 from a safe area, and we'll be there within 3 minutes to alleviate the situation.
Okay, so you've made your burgers, you've made your hot dogs, maybe steak, you're done. Mm-hmm. What do you do now? With the grill, of course.
Okay, so you shut off the grill, make sure you shut it off, and then you, the cylinder itself, the propane cylinder, you want to close that propane valve and make sure that's shut off completely. If you have anything burning there, I never leave my grill until it's fully out, until there's no more burning inside of there. So I don't have a propane grill, I have a charcoal grill. But I don't leave that unattended because you could have embers, whatever, that can just escape and cause a fire that you wouldn't be aware of unless you're there.
So that brings me to a lot of folks have grill covers. You certainly don't want to cover the grill prematurely.
You don't want to cover the grill. If you're covering the grill, you want to give a couple of days for the coals to cool off before you dispose of those as well.
That was a good point. I didn't realize a couple of days. I mean, it makes sense because heat can still, I suppose, hold itself within the charcoal, within the briquettes.
Absolutely, yeah. I mean, the top part might seem like it's out and the bottom is still cooking, and we have responded to garbage fires where that has been disposed of and it lit the garbage on fire. So you want to be careful of that.
You mentioned charcoal grills. Any other points regarding charcoal grills? You have one you'd mentioned.
I do have one, yeah. I think, again, the important thing is carbon monoxide poisoning. that can give off. So you just want to make sure that you use it in a well-ventilated area.
And talk about, I guess, fire pits. I understand fire can travel underground too.
Yeah.
What would you advise folks?
Well, a couple of things with fire pits, especially in the city of Quincy. There's no outside burning allowed in Quincy whatsoever.
Good point.
You can cook on the grills, but we don't have fire pit people policing the area to see what's if you have a fire pit or not.
Okay.
Normally, the complaints will come into the fire prevention office from a neighbor where smoke from the fire pit is going into their windows or whatever, and there has been fire pits that's lit fences on fire, and the city of Quincy being so condensed, it's not allowed in the city of Quincy. So, but with fire pits, it's illegal. But like you said, I mean, there can be fire starting in the roots underneath the pits, but in the city of Quincy, it's illegal to have them.
And we should mention, though, you go over to another town, they might not have the same ordinances that are set up here in the city, so be aware that if the town does have fire pits in use, that you certainly need to act safely around those areas.
Absolutely, absolutely. And I've seen, after my time in the military, I've been to social gatherings where there was a fire pit, and people have used gasoline to accelerate the fire, which is a big no-no. It's extremely explosive. You can get seriously hurt.
If you are operating a grill, pay attention. I mean, be at the grill.
Yeah.
Stepping away is not smart.
It's not. I mean, it's going to be a challenge, too, when you have a lot of people. You're at a social gathering. You might have a few things that could be interrupting your logic, you know, and causing you to get distracted. So, I mean, if you are having a party, if you have people over, there should be a dedicated grill person, specifically of just being in charge of that grill, maintaining the safety of the grill, not just that the burgers come out good, but you want to keep it safe.
Well, we certainly want folks to enjoy their grills, enjoy their seasons.
Right, right.
But keep in mind that to enjoy these niceties, I guess, you really have to pay attention to what could happen that could ruin.
Yeah.
The event could ruin lives.
Absolutely. It would totally dampen your party by having an accident that can quickly happen and get out of control relatively fast.
I think there was a video, I believe, that the National Fire Protection Agency put out years ago, and it basically showed how quickly a fire can escalate.
Mm.
I mean, extremely quickly. Yeah. People don't realize that it's almost, you know, the snapping of your fingers, and suddenly it becomes an out of control situation.
That's right. Yep, less than a minute, you can have a fully involved house fire.
Less than 60 seconds.
60 seconds, yep.
One last thing I'd like to mention to folks, if they have any questions regarding fire safety, they could call the office?
They always can, yeah, the Fire Prevention Office. Our number is 617-376-1015, and there's four of us that can answer any questions that you might have, so please feel free to call us at any time.
Great, and the City of Quincy has a website, and that is www.quincyma.gov. The fire department has a link on that site.
That's correct.
So yep. There's information there as well. Well, anything you'd like to add, or have we covered grill safety?
I believe we've covered grill safety pretty well. Yes, we have.
Good. Well, I want to thank you for coming in. Again, a great opportunity for you to come into the studios when they're grilling, when they're enjoying their outdoor facilities to really keep safety in mind.
Safety first. Absolutely.
Thank you.
Thank you, Mark.
Thank you at home for watching. You've been watching a program of Quincy Access Television and the Quincy Fire Department. Please continue to watch QATV for more locally produced programming.